Good morning. Today's Civil Engineering Online subject, Concrete Technology, Module 4, Concrete Mix Proportionating. Definition of mixed design. Mixed design can be defined as the process of selecting suitable ingredients of concrete and determining their relative proportions with the objective of producing concrete for certain minimum strength, durability and workability as economical as possible. The proportioning of ingredients of concrete is governed by the required performance characteristics in fresh and the hardened states. The definition itself says that we have to prepare a concrete of a certain minimum strength. Certain minimum strength of a concrete after 28 days, which is good in durability, also having the workability in its fresh state. Fresh state means when we are adding the water to the dry mix and we are preparing it as a plastic state, that time it will be a fresh state. That type of concrete will be in a fresh state. It has to be workable. Workable means we know that ease of mixing, transporting, placing, handling, compacting and finishing is known as workability. Also with economically. Economically means we should not be dependable upon the materials which are very far away available from the site. The material should be available near to the site such that the cost of the materials is less, which will result in preparing us a economical mix design. So this performances and the other state of conditions of concrete are also governed based upon the characteristics of concrete under the fresh state and hardened state, how we have proportioned the each individual ingredient of concrete. So each individual ingredient of concretes are cement, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, water, and if applicable or wherever we require, we can conduct as another ingredients called as admixtures. The admixtures may be mineral admixtures or may be chemical admixtures. Objective of concrete mix design. What is the need of mix design? What is the need? Why it is most required to prepare a mix design? Why can't we go with improper mixes? So the objective is to determine the most economical and practical combination of available materials like cements, aggregates, water admixtures, etc. to produce a concrete that will satisfy the performance requirements. As earlier explained, the various performance requirements for conventional concrete, usually we also know it as a normal concrete. Acceptable workability of fresh concrete, the able to workable concrete. Adequate durability and strength of hardened concrete. How much is the durability and strength of hardened concrete? Uniform appearance of hardened concrete. The appearance of hardened concrete after it gets setted totally. Satisfactory appearance of hardened concrete. Uniform appearance is separate. Satisfactory appearance is separate. Uniform appearance should have the same uniform color, which we are going to see after the hardening of concrete. Satisfactory appearance means it should not have any patching and all things. Means 10%, 10 by 10 of particular wall is there. If we consider 10 feet by width and 10 feet height, we are able to see the particular concrete wall. In that, we should not have any part of exposure or deterioration, that is known as small amount of satisfactory appearance of hardened concrete. Ease of mixing, able to be workable, transporting and placing with the available facilities. We should not have a well-equipped machineries, or we have to be the well-equipped machineries is not the strict condition. The condition is that we have to be with available facilities. Whatever is available for the preparing the concrete, that part is only considered under the objective. Economy. Main cement and other ingredients in some special cases. So mainly cement. Why mainly cement? Means cement has to be brought from the factory. And now we know there are many names of cements are available, and also many of them are having small changes in the properties, not as a much changes in their properties. This small changes of properties, if we compromise with a particular quality of cement, then the economy of the mixed design can be achieved easily. And ingredients such as coarse aggregates are available from some of the quarries which are nearby, or else we have to find it for the far away places of the quarries. Sand, moreover, nowadays sand is used as a manufactured sand, whereas river sand has been stopped of mining. For that reason, that part of sand whichever we are using has to be a proper material, because it should not disturb the mixed concrete after when we add the manufactured sand into the concrete. Moving to the factors affecting the choice of mix proportion. So what are the factors which are going to affect the mix design? So first factor which will affect the mix design is compressive strength required. Compressive strength is the one of most important properties of concrete and influences. Strength is generally specified at 28 days, generally governed by water to cement ratio. How much is the water to cement ratio we have added into the mix proportion, that will govern the strength of the concrete at 28 days. Proper compaction and curing. Proper compaction and curing are necessary to get the desired strength in concrete. So if we do proper compaction and curing of the concrete which we have laid at some specific places, if we do the correct part into that, we can able to achieve the desired strength of concrete. The compressive strength is the criteria for most concrete used in the building, which is considered as a measure of quality control. Second one, workability required. The degree of workability required depend mainly the size of the section to be considered. Mainly the size of the section to be considered, the amount of steel and the method of compaction adopted. Workability should be property defined depending on the type of structure and the type of compacting equipment available at the sites. The required workability should be adjusted using suitable admixtures. So workability, what we are achieving, that workability should be defined as per the mix proportion. They mention it as type of structure, depending upon the type of structure and the type of compacting equipment, the workability has to be defined. The workability which is required, it should be able to adjust by using the suitable admixtures. The admixtures may be of some mineral admixtures or chemical admixtures. To adjust the workability, we are going with the admixtures which are available as chemical admixtures, which are known as plasticizers, superplasticizers, retarders, etc. So some of the workability conditions which will be useful in the particular type of workability. So that part is mass concrete, lightly reinforced sections in slabs, beams, walls, columns and floors. So degree of workability, we consider them as under low degree. Slump vary in up to 25 mm to 75 mm. With the compaction factor instrument, it should give the workability range about 0.8 to 0.85. Same heavily reinforced sections which are slabs, beams, walls, columns and footings. These are heavily because in high rise structures, the reinforcement will be high. That is, we take under the medium degree of workability. Slump 50 to 100 mm, compaction factor 0.9 to 0.92, slip from work, that is pumped concrete in situ piling, these will be having high degree of workability, where maximum of compaction will not be considered. For that reason, highly workability we consider. Slump should be varying between 100 mm to 150 mm. So almost the slump is collapsed, and compaction factor nearly to the 0.95 to 0.96. More than 0.95 is achieved for nearly about 1. That is compaction factor which we have to consider. Remaining other factors are durability requirement. Durability requirement as specified in IS, Indian Standard 456-2000, should be strictly followed. So the durability is one more requirement which has to be taken under consideration after the concrete attains its hardened state. So how does the concrete will be able to take that much amount of load? How the concrete will be able to have that much amount of strength which can bear the load which is coming on it and easily transfer it to the footings or the base? Durability requirements with regard to cement content and water cement ratio mainly depend on the severity of the environment. So these all depend upon the severity of the environment. As the environment becomes critical, higher cement content and lower water cement ratio is as mentioned in IS 456-2000 should be used. So the depending upon environmental critical higher cement content and lower water cement ratio as mentioned in IS 456 should be used. Maximum cement content to avoid creep and shrinkage cracking due to temperature cycles as per IS 456 should be kept in mind. So content of cement should not be more. We have more amount of cement and easily we can put it into the concrete. That should not be taken into place wherein it will result for the having the creep and shrinkage of concrete after it settles due to the temperature cycles on the particular concrete structure. Fourth one, maximum nominal size of aggregate. The maximum nominal size of aggregate, in general, larger the maximum size of aggregate, smaller is the cement requirement for a particular water to cement ratio, because the workability of concrete increases with increase in maximum size of aggregate. So depending upon the water cement ratio, the workability of concrete is also going to change. If the workability increases, means the workability will be increasing the maximum size of aggregate. The compressive tends to increase with the decrease in the size of aggregate. Now, the particular type is what? Workable. If the higher grade or higher size of aggregates are there, they are able to easily flow into the water or easily able to settle into the formwork. For that reason, workability will be high. We don't want any type of other maximum compaction. But to have good strength, we cannot use the maximum size of aggregate or the larger size of aggregates. We have to use a small size of aggregate, which again tends to have the good compressive strength. And the decrease in aggregate size only can be achieved so that we can increase the compressive strength of concrete. Grading and type of aggregate. The grading of aggregate influences the mix proportion for a specified workability and water cement ratio. So grading means we usually prepare a sieve analysis. Sieve analysis will be giving us a particular type of material specified by its sizes. That is known as grading. So it will also influence the mix proportion for a specified workability. How much workability is required? That much amount of grading of that particular aggregate has to be added with respect to water cement ratio. The type of aggregate influences strongly the aggregate to cement ratio for the desired workability and stipulated water cement ratio. An important feature of a satisfactory aggregate is the uniformity of the grading, which can be achieved by mixing different size fractions. So we should not stick to only single size of aggregate. We have to use different size of fractions of the aggregates, which will result as a particular rate of workability, or else if we use only single size of aggregates, we are not able to have the proper workability of concrete. So this size is nothing but grid and type of aggregates. Quality control, the target strength of concrete. Target strength of concrete means one part of concrete strength which we have to achieve after the mix proportion. Depends on the quality of the concreting. Good quality control results in less standard deviation and hence the minimum cement content. So if we use good quality control results while mixing, adding water, adding cement, adding fine aggregate, adding coarse aggregate, that time results in the small amount of standard deviation. Standard deviation means 100 number of cubes are taken. Out of 100 number of cubes, if we are able to have 95% of cubes are with good result, 5% of cubes are with weak results. That 5% will be the deviation. That standard deviation has to be maintained and that will be giving us. And hence the minimum cement amount content has to be used. Use of admixture. The use of admixture is permitted as per IS 456 and IS 10262. Fly ash and GGBFS are generally used as mineral admixture. Plasticizers and SP, super plasticizers, are used as chemical admixtures. So usually depending upon the use of admixtures, we can go for the mineral admixture or chemical admixtures. Mineral admixtures are generally used to alter the quantity of either cement or fine aggregate. And the chemical admixtures are used to alter the workability, that is water quantity of the concrete. Moving to mixed design as per the IS 10262 as per the syllabus, Indian Standard 10262-2009. So procedure for preparing a mixed design. So step one is target strength for mixed proportioning. This is the strength which we have to achieve after the 28 days of curing of hard concrete. When we prepare a concrete, that mixed concrete has to be placed into a cube. It has to be cured for 28 days. After 28 days, when we are taking that cube for the mixed proportion, we have to, it will be having the 28 days of strength. That 28 days of strength is nothing but target strength which we have to achieve it. Where FCK dash, the target strength is given by FCK dash is equals to FCK plus 1.65S. So where FCK dash is equals to target mean strength at 28 days in Newton per mm square. FCK equals to characteristics compressive strength at 28 days in Newton per mm square. S is the standard deviation, Newton per mm square is there the result provided in the code book of 10262-2009. Selection of mixed proportions. Step 2. Selection of water to cement ratio. Different cement, supplementary cementitious materials and aggregates of different maximum size, grading, surface structure, shape and other characteristics may produce concretes of different compressive strength for the same free water cement ratio. Therefore, the relationship between strength and free water cement ratio should preferably established for the materials actually to be used. So, for the different cements, supplementary cementitious materials and aggregates of different sizes, texture, shape, other characteristics, also having the different compressive strength of concrete, we have some of the water cement ratio, free water cement ratio. The relationship between strength and water cement ratio should be preferably established for the materials actually to be used. The water cement ratio, which is given in table 5 of IS 456-2000, for respective environment exposure conditions may be used as the starting point for selection of water cement ratio. So this is the table 5 of IS 456-2000, minimum cement content, maximum water to cement ratio and minimum grade of concrete for different exposures with normal weight aggregates of 20 mm nominal size. So this table is for 20 mm size of coarse aggregate with the different exposures. So exposures are here: mild exposure, moderate exposure, severe exposure, very severe exposure, extreme exposure. So these are depending upon the conditions of the particular structure, wherein again we are able to get here some two categories: plain concrete without reinforcement, reinforced concrete with the steel embedded into the concrete. Minimum cement content, how much has to be considered? Maximum free water cement ratio, this is the water to cement ratio, and what will be the grade of concrete when we are going to use. So under plain concrete we can see that moderate range of exposure from M15 to extreme range of exposure, the grade of minimum concrete is about M25. Similarly, for reinforced concrete, the minimum grade of concrete is M20 mix having 20 Newton per mm square, and minimum grade of concrete at the 0.4 of water cement ratio, M40 is the particular grade of concrete. So this is the table taken from IS 456. Third step, selection of water content. So the water content of a concrete is influenced by a number of factors such as aggregate size, aggregate shape, texture, workability, water cement ratio, cement and other supplementary cementitious material, type and content, chemical admixture and environmental conditions. So water is depending upon all the factors of other materials. Whatever the materials we are using, their factors are going to consider for the selection of water content. The water content in table 2, this table is from IS 1062-2009, is for angular coarse aggregate and for 25 to 50 mm slump range. So the table 2 is given only for the slump which will have of 25 mm to 50 mm. The water cement water estimate in table 2 can be reduced by approximately 10 kg. So water 1 liter is equals to same and 1 kg is equals to same. So here units are used as kgs because other materials are also calculated as per kgs only. 10 kgs for subangular aggregates. 20 kg of gravel with some crushed particles and 25 kg for rounded gravel to produce same workability. Means the whatever which we are estimating can be reduced by approximately 10 kg. So if we consider 186, we can reduce it for 176 kg for subangular aggregates. For gravel and some crushed particles, we can reduce from 186 minus 20 kg, which will be 166 kg. And similarly, for rounded gravel to produce same workability, from 186 we have to reduce 25 kg. That will be the maximum water content. For a desired workability other than 25 to 50 mm slump range, so if we are able to have the slump away other than the 25 to 50 mm range, the required water content may be established by trial or an increase by about 3%. So if we have to increase 25 to 50 mm of slump other than this part, so for every change we can increase or establish a trial mix of water content by about 3% for every additional 25 mm. So now this table is going to give up to 25 to 50 mm. We require slump of about 100 mm. So 50 mm plus 25 mm plus 25 mm will give us 100 mm of slump. So for every 25 mm of slump, we have to add 3%. So similarly, if we require 100 mm of slump, we have to add 6%. 6% of water content
so that we are able to have the workability. So this table says that maximum water content per cubic meter, for 1 cubic meter of concrete, for nominal maximum size of aggregate. Nominal maximum size of aggregate means 20 mm maximum size. So there they have given also the maximum size up to 40 mm. So 10 mm, 20 mm, 40 mm. Maximum water content in kgs, 208 for 10 mm, 186 for 20 mm, 165 for 40 mm of aggregate sizes. So water content corresponding to saturated surface dry aggregate. So this water content is depending upon the saturated surface dry aggregate conditions. Moving to step number 4, calculation of cementitious material content. The cement and supplementary cementitious material content as per unit volume of concrete may be calculated from the free water to cement ratio of IS 10262/2009 clause number 4.1, which it will give, and the quantity of water per unit volume of concrete. So the whatever we have earlier calculated the free water cement ratio of IS 456, that table is again repeated here. So this is the from table 5 of IS 456-2000, the minimum cement content also we are able to find out in this material. So that is calculation of cementitious material. So earlier we used to have the maximum free amount of water cement ratio, and we are now taking the same table for the minimum cement content of the concrete grade which we are using. That is the usefulness of IS 456 with in relation to 10262. Step 5, estimation of coarse aggregate proportion. Aggregates of essentially the same nominal maximum size, type and grading will produce concrete of satisfactory workability. When a given volume of coarse aggregate per unit volume of total aggregate is used, approximate values for this aggregate volume are given by table 3 for a water cement ratio of 0.5, which may be suitably adjusted for the other water cement ratios. So table number 3 of 10262, what it says, volume of coarse aggregate, how much volume of coarse aggregate we have to consider per unit volume of total aggregate for different zones of fine aggregate. So volume of coarse aggregate divided by total volume of aggregate for different zones of fine aggregate. So fine aggregate is having 4 zones. We are able to see zone 1, zone 2, zone 3, zone 4. So maximum size of nominal coarse aggregate, if we choose 20 mm here and zone 3 as the fine aggregate, so for that 1 cubic meter of coarse total aggregate will have 0.64% of coarse aggregate. So fine aggregate would be of quantity 0.36. So that we are able to calculate the coarse aggregate proportion. So estimation of fine aggregate proportion after the completion of procedure given in step 5, the previous step. All the ingredients have been estimated except the coarse and fine aggregate content. These quantities are determined by finding out absolute volume of cementitious material. So cement's absolute volume we have to find out, water and chemical admixture, by dividing their mass by their respective specific gravity. So whatever the mass we have achieved, that we have to divide it by the particular respective specific gravity and multiplying by 1/1000 and subtracting the result of their summation from unit volume. So 1 minus the total addition of the individual material, what we are able to get, we are able to find out the particular calculation. The values so obtained are divided into coarse and fine aggregate fractions by volume in accordance with coarse aggregate proportion already determined in step 5. The coarse and fine aggregate contents are then determined by multiplying with their respective specific gravities and multiplying by 1000. So this step we can easily find out when we are solving the problems of mixed design. So after this video, I'll also provide the 10262-2009, the IS code link, wherein mixed proportions are able to do using that particular code book and some numericals. Thank you. Thank you for watching the video.